हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द मास्टर कैंप फॉर सॉलिड वर्क्स ट्यूटोरियल सीरीज। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द कंटूर मिलिंग ऑपरेशन, ऑल इट्स सेटिंग्स, एंड वी विल आल्सो वेरीफाई द कंटूर मिलिंग ऑपरेशन। सो फर्स्ट वी विल डू ए मॉडलिंग इन सॉलिड वर्क्स एनवायरनमेंट एंड देन विल ट्रांसफर टू द मास्टर कैंप फॉर सॉलिड वर्क्स कॉन्फिगरेशन विंडो and try to set up the contour milling operation. So I'll open the new part. So I'll start with the top plane. I'll take the corner rectangle method. Okay, try to model the rectangle. The dimensions of the rectangle are 150. By 120. Okay, we'll try to extrude this in the downward direction. So by default the direction is up. I'll change the direction to down, and the thickness is going to be 25 mm. Okay, now I'll apply some fillets, okay, on the corners. So on these two corners I'll have fillets of, let's say, 30 mm radius. And on the remaining two corners I will have fillets of, say, 50 mm radius. Okay, this is how the part looks. So now our aim is to have a rectangular workpiece, okay, rectangular raw material workpiece, and then try to do the side milling, or whatever we call it as contour milling. So it is going to follow this contour, and the milling cutter is going to mill the outer regions and retain this particular shape. Okay, retain this particular shape. So let us first save this. Okay, so the part is fully defined. Okay, I'll switch to the MasterCAM toolpath manager. Okay, and as you can see, since we have already taken the top plane as the plane to draw the first sketch, okay, it aligns with the MasterCAM top plane as well. I'll go into the files, okay, and in the machine group properties I'll go to tool settings. I'll give the appropriate number. So I'll give 1001 as the program number. Okay, we will keep feed calculations from material. Okay, so whatever material we select, okay, feed calculations will depend on that. Assign tool number sequentially. Okay, warn off duplicate tool numbers. So I'll change the material from here. So mill library, I'll select steel 304. Okay, I'll select steel 304 as the material, and then I'll go into the stock setup. Remember stock setup, we have to have the we can either select corners, but now this doesn't have any corners. So what we can do, we will go to the bounding box. We will go to the bounding box option. Can select the faces, okay, extreme two faces, and say okay. And there it selects the bounding box. Now we can give, let's say, some additional dimensions, okay, by increasing the these dimensions. So let's say if I increase make it 160, okay, so 5 5 mm will be added along X. So 5 here 5 here, and total will be 160. If I increase this to 130, same thing will be done. So 5 5 will be added, okay, on the Y, and total dimension is 130. Now we will not add more dimension in Z axis right now, because we are only going to see contour milling, that is the side milling. So we'll run the toolpath in such a way that, or create the toolpath in such a way that these additional corners are removed, and we are retaining with the workpiece, or that is the end workpiece which we have modeled. Okay, so I'll say okay to this. Okay, and we have got our required dimension. In X it is 160, in Y it is 130, and Z it is 25. Okay, so I'll say okay to this, and yeah, the stock setup was perfectly fine. Okay, now we can move to the toolpath group. Right click on this, come to the mill toolpath, and the first option is contour. So it is contour milling. Click on this. Now here I have to select the toolpath. So now how do I select? I want my milling cutter to follow this edge. Okay, to follow this edge, and then again come back to the normal position. So while doing that, how we are going to select? So what I do when it highlights, okay, I've just bring my cursor on the edge, okay, it automatically highlights, and then you have to right click and say select loop. So with this arrow you can transfer between the selections. Okay, this edge is common between this surface and this surface. So what we want to select all these edges. So what it does, it forms the loop, okay, of all these edges, and gives us loop one. So this is the selection that we want. I'll say okay to this, and then it goes into the contour milling. Okay, then it goes into the contour milling. So this is contour. Okay, this is the contour milling what we are looking for. We will be seeing more milling operations like pocket milling, face milling, slot milling, okay, in the coming lectures. So for doing this milling, okay, we will require a flat end mill. Okay, we will require a flat end mill. So we'll go into the select library tool, and we'll say filter. So by default end mill flat is selected. Okay, I'll say equal to 15 mm, and we'll see if there are tools available. Now there is no tool available with diameter 15 mm, so what we'll do, we'll go with 10 mm flat end mill. Okay, 10 mm flat end mill, 10 mm flat end mill is available, so we'll select that. Okay, it appears over here. Then we'll move into the holder. Then we will move into the holder. So as you can see, this is the length. Okay, this is the length, the cutting length. The green zone is the cutting length of the tool. Okay, so we need to be very sure when we are trying to achieve this depth. Okay, this depth, what is going to be my depth of cut? Okay, so we'll decide all those parameters, and let the default holder be selected. Okay, so we go into the cut parameter. Now in this cut parameter, it is very important to set the compensation direction. Okay, to set the compensation direction. So this arrow pointing the direction of tool, and this so this is going in the up direction, or you can say this arrow is the edge of the workpiece. Okay, and this circle represents the tool. So if I say left, so onto the left of the edge, and it is going in the up direction. When I say right, so it is going to be on the right of the edge and going in the up direction. So we'll keep it by default at this point of time as left. Okay, now flat end mill doesn't have a tip. Okay, so this tip compensation option, even if we specify tip or center, okay, it doesn't really change things for flat end mill, because flat end mill doesn't have a tip. Okay. Now stock to leave on walls, stock to leave on floors. Say if you are doing something on the if you are doing something like pocket milling, then these options are very useful. So we can have an initial cut with a by specifying more material to be removed, and we can leave some stock on walls and floors for a finer cut at the later stage. So as far as this option is concerned, cut parameters, we will go with right now left compensation direction. We'll come into the depth of cut. So we will require to activate depth of cut. Maximum rough step I'll set up as 5 millimeters. Okay, maximum finish cuts are actually not required because along the depth we are not actually doing anything. So 5 mm is also enough. Okay, finish step you can give, or you can go without that also. So what happens, okay, as if you want to retain the geometry which is at the bottom, okay, then the finish cut for depth of cut matters. But since we are doing only contour milling, so every time what is a depth that we want to remove from the sides, that is what the depth of cut means. So if I am giving maximum rough step as 5, so there will be 5 total steps, okay, in which this 25 mm total thickness will be removed. Okay, so I'll say keep tool down, but since we don't have a finish cut to run, okay, so this option doesn't matter. Okay, this option doesn't matter. We'll see the option in the pocket milling where it matters. Okay, then so the maximum rough step with which the tool is going to come down in the Z direction is 5. Okay, is 5. So right now I have 25 mm depth to achieve. So since my maximum rough step is 5 mm, I will require 5 steps or 5 iterations to remove the entire 25 mm depth. Lead in, lead out, the direction from where the tool will come in contact with the workpiece, and from where it is going to start following the tool path. So that is what it specifies. So I have say lead in, lead out. It is very useful option in contour milling. Okay, it is very useful option in contour milling. So I'll say use entry point. Okay, use entry point. And so all these options, okay, adjust the start of the contour, I'll say 100%, and transfer these properties onto the exiting side as well. So this is going to be the entry, this is going to be the exit side. Okay, then breakthrough. Breakthrough is required because we want to cut off the side edges as well. Okay, so I'll specify some breakthrough amount as 1 mm. Okay, so milling cutter will try to come slightly down so that I will not be having any burrs on the bottom face. Okay, burrs on the bottom face. Now multipass, this is very important property. So multipass, since my diameter is 10 mm, rough cut number, okay, that I want to remove, I'll keep it as 5, and spacing let it be 5. एंड द स्पेसिंग शुड बी लेस देन द डायमीटर ऑफ द कटर. ओके, स्पेसिंग शुड बी द स्पेसिंग शुड बी लेस देन द डायमीटर ऑफ द कटर. ओके, फिनिश नंबर आई वुड रिक्वायर लेट्स से 2. स्पेसिंग इज आई विल रिड्यूस द स्पेसिंग टू 0.5. ओके, अप्लाई टू ऑल फिनिश पासिस. देन ओवर राइड फीड स्पीड. राइट नाउ वी विल नॉट यूटिलाइज दीज ऑप्शंस. ओके, विल गो विथ कीप टूल डाउन. सो वेन इट इज गोइंग अंडर गोइंग रफ कट, ओके, इट विल बी हैविंग सम फीड. ओके, वेन इट इज गोइंग टू डू द फिनिश कट, ओके, द फीड एंड स्पीड फीड विल बी स्लाइटली रिड्यूस्ड, ओके, टू अचीव गुड सर्फेस फिनिश. सो वाइल इट इज डूइंग दैट वी विल नॉट टेक द टूल अप एंड चेंज द फीड एंड अगेन कम डाउन. सो दैट इज वाई कीप टूल डाउन इज अ हैंडी ऑप्शन टू रिड्यूस सम इलैप्स टाइम ऑफ द मशीनिंग. ओके, सो मल्टीपास ऑर्डर बाय कंटूर एंड रफ पास कट डायरेक्शन इज वन वे. देन आर देर एनी टैब्स? ओके, सो वी डोंट require any tabs right now. Okay, so we'll go into the linking parameter, which is very important property. Make sure everything is in absolute mode. Okay, make sure everything is in absolute mode. Okay, first I'll select the depth. So depth I will select as this. So depth is -25. Top of stock is this, which is 0. Okay, feed plane, I can keep feed plane at 10, okay, whatever the default value. Retract is 25 and clearance is 50. Okay, clearance is 50. Then home reference position. Okay, home reference position is whatever the specified value, by default specified value. So it is well away from the workpiece. Okay, also in linking parameter, see these options as it clearly specifies over here. So depth is what is the total depth that we want to cut. Since we are going to do the side milling or contour milling, from the sides we are going to reduce the part. Okay, and total depth that we want to cut is 25 mm, so it is -25. Top of stock is the top plane. Okay, feed plane is the plane in which the object or the cutter is going to move with the spindle still on. Okay, so spindle on and still it is in a feed mode, so that is feed plane. So till 10 mm height spindle can be on. Okay, retract is a place, the plane wherein the spindle will be shut off. Okay, so at 25 height spindle will be switched off. Okay, at clearance is a distance where the tool change can be carried out. So clearance is a further up where tool change can be initiated. So I hope this is understood. Home reference position, okay, we are keeping defaults. Okay, then arc filter tolerance, okay, not required. The tolerances for arc, whatever setup, okay, are, we'll use the by default values. Then planes, as we have modeled this in the top plane, so it coincides with the master cam working coordinates, tool planes and construction planes. Then coolant, since it is contour milling, flood type coolant will switch on. Okay, we'll apply all these properties and check how it sets up the tool. Now as you can see, the tool path, it shows which is somewhere in between. Okay, which is somewhere in between. Actually, we want to remove the outer part, okay, whatever specified by this dotted line. So what has happened? The compensation direction got reversed. So as I told you initially, compensation direction is up to us to decide. So we'll go with compensation direction right. Say okay. And as you can see, when I changed parameters, the operation becomes dirty. So I'll say regenerate all dirty operations. And now as you can see, this is the tool path that it has generated. The tool is coming in contact with the workpiece at this location. Okay, and that is how it is coming in contact. Okay, following the multi passes, whatever we have specified. Remember, it will start from the outer side and slowly it will remove material and then come into the inner side. So that is how the tool path looks like. So what we will do, just to verify the tool path, whatever we have set up, is proper, we will verify the selected operations. So I'll click on the verify selected operations and I'll wait till the verify selected operation window loads. And so as you can see, the tool is well away from the workpiece. I'll slightly slower down the speed and then we'll try to see how it removes the material. So this is the first pass, this is the second pass. So these are the depth of cuts whatever it is achieving. Okay, depth of cuts whatever it is achieving. So as you can see, it is comfortably removing all the material. Okay, comfortably removing all the material, and we have retained the required, we have retained the required workpiece shape. Okay, comfortably. So with different fillet radius. Okay, it is comfortably retaining the required shape as we wanted. So I hope you have understood this. Okay, this is a simple contour milling operation. Okay, exactly similar to what you have been doing in the manual milling operations. Okay, the code that is used is G0. Now G00 is a code which is used for the rapid travel. So from home position till the point of contact, the tool will move in a rapid manner. Okay, it will use the maximum feed that is provided by the machine, and then it will start moving according to the machine specific or the program specific feed. So I hope you have understood. Okay, this was a very simple task to set up the contour milling operation on the MasterCAM for SolidWorks software. So I'll see you next time with more such interesting content on the computer aided manufacturing using MasterCAM for SolidWorks. Till then, thank you and goodbye.